Okay, here's a real quick video I'm going to make of my latest project. I've been working on a 1958 Seeburg Jukebox. Really cool looking machine. It's one of the older style ones where you can actually see the record mechanism in action, where it scans and plays the records and you can see it the whole time. This one's also really neat. The bottom styling here, a bit on the side here, it basically has taillights and fins, exactly almost like you would see on the cars of the 50s. So it really kind of captures that era and style with this jukebox. Lots of chrome on this unit, and the unit itself was actually in pretty good shape when I got it. Cosmetically, we just needed to give it a real good cleaning and shine her up, and she came up pretty good. We did rebuild the selection receiver, also rebuilt the amplifier. The record mechanism here that scans and plays the records, that got taken apart and cleaned up, and so working 100% now, so looks and sounds good. This unit plays 160 different selections. There's 80 records in it, and it can play either side of those 80 records to give you the 160 selections on it. What I'll do now is I'll fire up a selection on here so we can see the mechanism in action, and you can also hear how it sounds. So we'll put in A5. A5 is Sleepwalk by Santo and Johnny. Really cool piece, and I feel like it's appropriate for this jukebox. And I'll also turn the lights off so you can see what it looks like with the in the dark. Kind of gives you an idea of how it looks and sounds, and the sound on this is actually really remarkable. I don't think this camcorder is going to give it any type of justice, but this amplifier is from the 50s obviously, and it's all tubes, so there's no digital sound processing, digital amplification. This is completely analog, and it sounds really good. An upgrade that I did to this, or added, is we have a full function remote control. That's really nice because the volume controls and the power switch, they're all located on the back of the jukebox. So anytime you want to change the volume or turn the thing on and off, you had to scramble behind there. So with the remote, we can simply turn down the volume from anywhere, turn it back up. And you can also cancel any selection that's playing. So if we wanted to end this, we can simply hit the button and you'll see it's going to put the record back. And basically it's going to scan the record bank just to make sure no other selections were chosen. And it'll come at rest on the right hand side here, which is basically like the home position. So real cool looking unit, real nice looking, lots of chrome on it. And one other thing that I do have hooked up to this, I'll take a quick look, walk across the game room here, is a wall box. And the wall boxes were typically found in diners and restaurants, and you would see these either at the counter where you're sitting, or they might even be actually right at the booth there. And the cool thing is with these is it allowed you to make selections on the jukebox without having to get up from your table or wait in line for the jukebox. This one I have, it is hooked up, controls the jukebox, and you can make your selections from this as well. So we'll fire one of these up and show you how that works as well. We'll do Stand By Me, which is N3. And if we walk over back to our jukebox now, we should see that mechanism is scanning the record bank. And it's going to pick it up and play, hopefully, Stand By Me. There you have it. This is a 1958 Seeburg jukebox with the working wall box attached to it. Really cool sounding and looking jukebox. When the night has come,
and the land is dark, and the moon is the only